copy of a copy of a copy. Hello YouTube, this is Jericho Majors coming back after a long wait. I'm sure all of you have been wondering where I've been. I'm sorry I did not finish that series of reviews I was doing on last season. Complications happened, my computer got switched around, and if you want, you know, you can comment and I will make those videos about those episodes because I do have a lot of opinions about them, but that is not what this episode or video is about. This video is regarding the one company's coming Sonic remote, the 10th Doctor's remote based on the season 3 through 4 Sonic, and just like kind of giving information that most people wouldn't know or some people might not know, and just kind of providing some information that you might not see on other websites. Now, first off, we are going to talk about accuracies and specific things that most people would really care about with this, considering its price tag of $110 US. Now, it is $108 plus tax, but you round that up to $110, and with shipping, you're probably looking at $120 to $125, buying from the right side. I recommend buying it from Firebox. They are selling it on BBCAmerica.com, but I recommend buying it from Firebox. Now, accuracies. This particular product was actually based on a 3D scan of David Tennant's personal prop that he took off the set of Doctor Who on his final run. Now, that prop is commonly referred to as the B prop because there was an A and B prop of season 3 through 4. That each have very slight minor differences. One of them being on the B prop, there were I'm gonna be using this laptop to show you pictures because my printer does not work. So we'll see how that looks. Pretty good. I'll just explain what colors don't. Up on the struts, about right here, there were little chips. Now they 3D scanned it completely and actually got the crackle effect on the cracked porcelain pommel or grip. I guess you would call it center body, the cracked porcelain center body. They actually got the particular crackle effect exactly replicated and are doing injection molded plastic to make it more durable and accurate. Now, there were little kind of imperfections in the prop itself that they smoothed out and they make this look brand new. There are some, that's the only thing that makes this inaccurate in any way. There were some things they smoothed out that made it look much better than the actual prop. Now, first off, the center body, the center of the acrylic, you cannot see it in the picture. It actually looks like it in there. Oh, there it is, okay. The center of the acrylic rod that they is what they used for, I think in the show it was glass. This is using acrylic to be more durable. It is not a frosted channel. Now what that means is what the yellow wire goes through in the acrylic is supposed to be dug out kind of sloppily and look frosty, kind of like frosted glass. This does not have that feature. That was one of the only, probably the only thing besides the black and pommel, I guess, which is the Delrin cup that I had a problem with. And I'll get to that in a second. By the way, Brody's here. Anyone who is wondering, he was in one of my first couple of videos that got a couple thousand views. So thanks, guys. Anyways, the center of the acrylic rod is not frosted. That's probably the only thing I don't like about this. Other features that make it very very accurate. And I'll scroll down. Talking about this, the top kind of this entire head. Some people have been complaining that the top bevel was too large, and actually, the heads of the season 3 through 4 Sonic was, or the head of the season 3 through 4 Sonic was recycled from the Aztec prop, which is what we've seen in season 1 and 2. Most people wouldn't know that. I do. Now, Also, as I said, the porcelain, the cracked porcelain effect, which is not actual porcelain in the show. Let me reinforce that. I believe it was made of brass and then painted on to look like cracked porcelain by Nicarbato himself. The pictures I'm showing you are of a prototype seen at Comic-Con, painted by Nicarbato. So, all of the videos, one of which is on firebox.com, I highly recommend you go watch it because it's an amazing video. It shows off some of the features that I'll talk about. What was I saying? No, I'm joking. This was painted by Nicarbato, so we don't know what the final product will look like.
This is really fun.
Yeah. We don't know what the final product will look like specifically, but if it's anything close to what we saw in the video on Firebox, as I'll probably put a link down in the description. It's beautiful. It's really amazing. It rivals Celestial Toy Store's replicas by, like, just, it rivals him, like, very well. Celestial Toy Store is known for being kind of rude and very abrasive about how accurate his replicas are as opposed to other people. I don't have a problem with that. I think it's great that he has kind of monopolied the market of Sonic Screwdriver replicas, but now it's time to kind of step aside because this company is making one that is not only a replica, but is also functional as a universal remote. The slider button, as I will show you now, if I can get you a picture of it, the slider button is not as low as it should be on the screwdriver. The slider usually should come down to about, okay. As you'll see on this picture, right here, the slider button comes up to about here and should perfect picture. On the bottom here, you'll see the Millennium FX replica, which came out in 2008. You'll see the slider comes back to the second notch and a little bit back. They were too far back. The wand company is coming up to the first notch, which is too short. It actually comes directly to here and looks as though it comes down that far. So they're both in the middle. I prefer the wand company, what they're doing, because the prop itself, when pulled back all the way on the slider, is really probably hard to hold for some people. Now, the Delrin cup, which is on the prop itself, as I say, made of Delrin. On the Millennium FX, I don't know if it was made of Delrin, but they went with a hardened rubber in the prototype, and then talking to Richard B. from the One Company on the RPF, he stated that it's made of polypropylene, which is what, if anyone has heard that before.
No way.
Polypropylene? Oh. You'll see that in cold steel sparring weapons, which right there tells you that it's very durable and very reliable plastic. They're using that. It actually detaches from the Sonic itself to reveal a micro USB charger. If I can remember correctly. Yeah, it's a charger. There's a picture up here. Now, everything else, there you go. Take it off. Looks like that. If you know what that kind of charger that is, good for you. Now, I'm going to go on to talk about the features in actually another video, because this one's getting a little too long, because I want to give you as much information as possible in one video. So, yeah, there will be a link in the description to the second part of this video. Thanks for watching.